गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल रीड क्लास 10th मैथमेटिक्स चैप्टर 13, दैट इज सरफेस एरियाज एंड वॉल्यूम्स। इन क्लास 9th और इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस, क्लास 6, क्लास 7, क्लास 8, क्लास 9, इन ऑल क्लासेस यू आर रीडिंग दिस चैप्टर सरफेस एरियाज एंड वॉल्यूम्स। वी लर्नड ऑल अबाउट हाउ टू फाइंड द एरियाज ऑफ टू डायमेंशनल फिगर्स, द सरफेस एरियाज ऑफ थ्री डायमेंशनल फिगर्स, द वॉल्यूम ऑफ थ्री डायमेंशनल फिगर्स लाइक दैट ऑफ क्यूब, क्यूबॉइड, सिलेंडर, कोन, स्फीयर, सेमीस्फीयर एटसेट्रा। बट इन दिस क्लास 10th, दिस चैप्टर सरफेस एरियाज वॉल्यूम, वी विल डिस्कस हाउ टू फाइंड द सरफेस एरिया एंड वॉल्यूम्स ऑफ कंबाइंड सॉलिड्स। फर्स्ट विल डिस्कस अबाउट द सरफेस एरिया ऑफ ए कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ सॉलिड्स। वेल, टू सॉलिड्स आर कंबाइंड, टू आर मोर देन टू सॉलिड्स आर कंबाइंड, एंड हाउ कैन यू फाइंड surface areas? Let one cone is surmounted by a hemisphere, like here it is a cone that is surmounted by a hemisphere. We can find the surface area of this combined solid by finding the curved surface area of cone and curved surface area of hemisphere. When a cylinder is surmounted on a cone, this cylinder is surmounted on a cone, or a cone is surmounted by a cylinder. If you want to find the surface area of this solid, you can find the surface area of this cylinder plus surface area of cone. Let a cuboid is surmounted by a hemisphere, then we can find the surface area of this combined solids. Two solids are there, one cube and another hemisphere. By finding the surface area of this cubes, this cube and surface area of this hemisphere, when we add. But one thing is, when the hemisphere is lying on the top of this or one side of this cube, then this part will be neglected. The surface area of cube is neglected only by this part where it is covered by the hemisphere. So for every combined solid we can find its surface area. Let's discuss how we can find its surface area by doing some examples. Rashid got a flying top at his birthday present, which surprisingly had no color on it. He wanted to color it with his crayon. The top is shaped like a cone surmounted by a hemisphere. The entire top is 5 cm in height and the diameter of top is 3.5 cm. Find the area has to color.
Yeah, the question is Rasik got a flank top as his birthday party. Top, that means lucky. And we said no color on it. He wanted to color that present, that top. The top is like the shell of a cone surmounted by hemisphere. A cone surmounted by hemisphere. This one is a cone. That is surmounted by hemisphere. This one is cool, surmounted by hemisphere. The entire top is 5 cm in height. The total top, that is from this point to this point, it is 5 cm in height. And the diameter of the top is 3.5 cm. This one is the diameter. That is 3.5 cm diameter. It is the height. Then find the area he has to color. We have to find the area that needs to color. Means the area that is needed to color is equal to the surface area of this top, and this surface area is the area of the cone and area of the hemisphere. When we add area of the cone and area of that hemisphere, then we get area of the top, surface area of the top, that is used to color. So let's solve it. The top is exactly like an object having a cone is surrounded by a hemisphere. One solid is there. That is total surface area of the top. Here, total surface area of the top is equal to curved surface area of the cone plus curved surface area of the hemisphere. That is curved surface area of cone plus curved surface area of hemisphere. Curved surface area of cone. Here, for cone, we know the formula to find the curved surface area of any cone. That is equal with pi RL. Pi RL. But here it is not given the slant height and also the radius. But it is given that diameter, which is equal to 3.5 cm. We can find the radius. 3.5 by 2, half of the diameter, which becomes to 1.75. After getting the radius, we have to find the slant height, that is the value of L, by using Pythagoras theorem. Here, but it needs the height of the cone, that is S. We can find this height. Let this side is S, which can be obtained from the height given, the height of the top, that is given as 5 cm. We have to subtract this 5 cm from this 5 cm to the radius of that hemisphere. Since this one is half of 3.5, this one also half of 3.5, because both are the radius of same hemisphere, both becomes equal. So when this radius will be subtracted from this height 5 cm, then we get height of the cone. With this radius and height, we can find this slant height. Let it is the total height of the height of the total height of the top, it is the height of cone. Let H, that is the I top top, which is given as 5 cm, and this diameter is given as 3.5 cm. Then radius becomes equal to 3.5 by 2 cm. Take this smallest as a height of the hoop.
That is 3.25 cm.
LCM becomes 2, which is 10 minus 3.5. That is 6.5 by 2, which is 3.25 cm.
3.25 cm.
By using this height and radius, we can find the slab height. A value of n can be obtained by finding the square root of h square plus r square.
That's equal to 3.5.
The value of h is 3.25 whole square, and that of r square is 3.5 by 2 whole square. It is 3.25 square plus 3.5 by 2 whole square. It becomes equal to 3.76 approximately. Approximately we'll get here 3.76. Now we got that value of n here. We can find easily that CSE of cone that by using pi RL. Now, total surface area of the solid, that is CSE of cone, is pi RL plus CSE of hemisphere. For a sphere, the TSA will, the Earth surface area will be 4 pi R square, but in case of hemisphere, it is 2 pi R square. 2 pi r square. In both quantities are present pi r, the radius are equal. So take this pi r common. It becomes l plus 2 r. Now put the value. Pi, which is not mentioned in the question, we can take it 22 by 7. Then value of r, radius is 3.5 pi. Then l, which is equal to 3.7 plus 2 into r, 2 into 3.5 pi. Directly you can write 2r is the value. That is the diameter, which is equal to 3.5. Since it is area, we can use cm square. Now, 2 11 7 0.5. It is 11 into 0.5 into 3.7 plus 3.5, which is equal to 7.2 cm square. This
11 into 0.5 into 7.2 becomes equal to 39.6 cm square.
So this 39.6 cm square area
Let's do one more example here. The decorative block made of two solids, a cube and hemisphere. The base of the block is a cube with edge 5 cm and the hemisphere fixed on the top has a diameter of 4.2 cm. Find total surface area of the block.
Here it is given the decorative block according to this figure that is made of one cube and one hemisphere. The base of the cube, the base of the block is a cube having edge 5 cm. So each edge of this cube is 5 cm.
That of the hemisphere
heads the base radius is the base diameter is 4.2 cm. This diameter is 4.2 cm. This diameter is 4.2 cm and age of the cube is 5 cm. We have to find the total surface area of this combined solid, of this block, that combined solid. How can you find the total surface area of this combined solid? By finding the surface area of the cube and surface area of the hemisphere which is exposed here. The surfaces which are exposed, that should be estimated. So which surfaces are exposed? It is 5 surfaces of the total 5 surfaces of the cube which exposed, and some parts of this top also exposed, except the part that is covered by hemisphere. And for that hemisphere, only its part surface area is exposed. So let's calculate it. First, we have to count all the surface area, that is the total surface area of the cube, right? Let this one is the this top part, the top portion of the cube that is covered by hemisphere in this way. This part is covered by the hemisphere. Here, the except this top, all 5 surfaces is used to calculate. We have to add the surface area of all these 5 surfaces. And for this top part, we have to calculate only this much area because it is covered by the hemisphere. So first, we have to calculate the surface area of all the 6 faces and just subtract this part that is covered. We'll get surface area of the cube. After that, we'll add the top surface area of the hemisphere. First, total surface area of the cube, that is 6a square. 6 into a square, a square, that is the area of each face, because each of the side A, that is given as 5 cm. Then total surface area of the cube becomes 6a square. We can calculate it. 6 into a square, that is 5 square. 6 into 25 becomes 150 cm square. Here the total surface area of that cube is 150 cm square, but we have to subtract this much area from this 150 cm square. So what is the area of this circular part? It is pi r square, because it is a circle and area becomes equal to pi r square. We will put the values later. Next, find the top surface area of this hemisphere. Next, curved surface area of the hemisphere. In case of sphere, the curved surface area, which is equal to the total surface area, that is given as 4 pi r square. We use 4 pi r square for a sphere. But in case of hemisphere, that is half of the sphere, that is 2 pi r square. But this 2 pi r square is the curved surface. In case of sphere, all the surfaces are curved. So total surface is 4 pi r square.
but in case of hemisphere, that curved surface is half of that sphere, that is half of 4 pi r square becomes 2 pi r square, but it has one plane surface also. So total surface area becomes 3 pi r square, but here it is exposed only the curved surface. So curved surface area in this sphere is 2 pi r square. Next, we will count the total surface area of the block.
Total surface area of the block, which is equal to surface area of cube plus surface area of hemisphere
minus base area of the hemisphere.
That is total surface area of the cube minus base area of the hemisphere plus curved surface area of the hemisphere. Here, total surface area of the cube is obtained as 150 cm square, 150 minus base area of the hemisphere is pi r square plus curved surface of the hemisphere is 2 pi r square. Now we can put the value 150 minus 2 pi r square, minus pi r square plus 2 pi r square becomes plus pi r square. This much cm square. That is 150 plus 22 by 7. Next, radius. Since diameter is 4.2, then radius will be 4.2 by 2, that is equal to 2.1 cm. So radius square is 2.1 into 2.1. It is 2.1 into 2.1 cm square. Now it becomes 0.3. This equal with 150 plus 22 into 2.1 into 0.3. That's equal to 13.86 cm square, which becomes equal to 163.86. 163.86 cm square. So this 163.86 cm square is the total surface area of this decorative block.
In this way, we can find the surface area of any combined split. Okay.